Hey YouTube, this is Detroit Borg, and this is the Verco. This is a cover for the MacBook Air keyboard. This is a silicone cover with some very interesting properties, and this was sent to me by the folks at Cover-Rearth, who also make some very good iPhone and iPod Touch cases. And so it does come in this cardboard envelope, so let's go ahead and open it up. And here we have the Verco. It's a very nice package. Let's set this aside. And they did include these rings. These are actually plugs for the headphone jacks on iPod Touches, iPhone 4s, whatever. And those are pretty handy. They do sell these on their website. And it's rings, R-I-N-G-Z. Now on the back, you see some of the benefits of having a silicone keyboard cover. It prevents spills, dirt, dust, whatever, from getting into your keyboard. Essentially, your computer is right under your keyboard. So if you spill anything on it, you're likely to damage your computer. So it's often a good idea to keep it covered. And of course, it does reduce some noise. The silicone basically reduces the sound that's coming from your keys, so it's a little quieter under operation. And for me, the biggest benefit of using a silicone keyboard is to prevent wear on the keys themselves. The keys have a textured finish on them, and with wear, they do turn shiny, so it doesn't look as good over time. And some information about this product. It is called the Verco. It's made of silicone, manufactured by Cover-Rearth, and made in South Korea, but designed in the USA. And there are some other interesting principles about this material. It is a silicone, but it's covered with a polyimer coating. So it has a better texture and feel to the surface of it. It's not as sticky as silicone tends to be. Silicone will pick up hair, dust, and everything else that comes in contact with it. This coating will help to shed that off and makes a better feel for it. All right, to get this out, all we have to do is tear this open. The cover slides right out. Now, if we look at the cover, we can see it is very lightweight and it is very thin. This is definitely the thinnest silicone keyboard cover I've ever purchased. You can see on the surface this sort of glaze on it. Again, this is that polyimer coating, which helps to prevent dust and dirt from getting stuck onto it. And again, it is slipperier on this surface than underneath. This is just the raw silicone, so this is stickier, so it sticks to the keys better. But the surface itself is very slippery. It actually feels like the keys themselves, so that's kind of nice. On the edge, you'll see these basically these notches, and this is part of the ventilation system. Because the MacBook Air breathes through its keys, it needs some sort of ventilation in order to allow air to pass through, so this is part of that. Now, it should be noted that you do have a little nub here for the home keys, which is very useful, and we have the Cover-Rearth logo on the space bar. Now another thing you may notice, it's hard to detect, but if I sort of twist it in the light, you'll see that the center part of the keys themselves are sort of sunken in, and each key has a sort of bezel around it. Well, that's part of the design of the keyboard case or keyboard cover itself. This relief point around the edge, there's basically less material around the edge of the key. This makes it easier to operate. Most silicone cases don't have this sort of design, they're just solid. But with this, it allows the silicone itself to press down more easily. Now here I am with my MacBook Air. This is the 11-inch MacBook Air. And the MacBook Air has a smaller row of keys at the top, which makes it unique in the Apple lineup. It's the only computer with this slightly different keyboard design. So specific keyboard covers need to be made to fit the specific computer. The 13-inch MacBook Air, the MacBook Pros, of all sizes from 13 to 15 to 17-inch, and the polycarbonate MacBook don't have different keyboards. They all have the same keyboard, rather. So again, all you have to do is put this on and it will automatically fall into place. Now with the keyboard cover on, you can barely see it. It does have this smoky color to it, so it's not exactly invisible, but it's very low profile. You can see the edge right here, so it sort of picks up when you roll your finger over it. Now on the side, you can see those ventilation channels, which again helps air to breathe under the keyboard cover. Now let's go ahead and start typing and see how this sounds. So there you go. Now let's remove it and see how it sounds now. So clearly it is quieter when you're using the keyboard cover. Because the material around the edge of each key is thinner than the material in the center, when you press the key itself, you can actually see the material flexing at the edge. It basically allows the keyboard cover to work with the keys themselves. You're not getting much resistance, so it actually feels like you're not using the keyboard cover at all. Overall, I'm very happy with this keyboard cover. It's definitely the best silicone cover I've ever used on a MacBook. I have to say it's probably the only one I'm actually going to use over time. Every silicone keyboard cover I've used before hasn't been this well engineered and just hasn't worked very well. They've been very stiff and hard to use, and they generally don't feel very comfortable. This one is cleverly designed, and it is very inexpensive at only $12.99. I have to say without a doubt that if you have a MacBook Air, this is definitely the keyboard cover you should be grabbing. So once again, guys, this is Detroit Borg with a look at the Verco from Rearth. Thanks for watching.